Hey, welcome back to Right on the Money, the go-to resource for your financial decisions. Again, our guest today, Greg LaValle, President and CEO of Retirement Advisors at Financial Square. And so we've been talking about, you know, a little bit about current events, a little bit about taxation. And Greg, you mentioned Roth conversions, and I don't want it nothing political, but I think it's safe to say that there's a lot of things that we have to pay for as citizens. So taxes, I don't think I need to be Punxsutawney Phil to say that taxes are probably going to have to go up at some point. And you mentioned Roth conversions. Can you talk a little bit about that as a strategy? And you know, explain it just a little bit for those folks that are hearing of Roth conversions for the first time.
Sure. You know, people go to work every day and they don't realize that our U.S. debt is now at over $26 trillion. And it's going up dramatically. And certainly the pandemic is adding to the U.S. deficit. And so someone has to pay for that at some point. And so just 10 years ago, it was only $15 trillion. So now as this climbs, at some point, Americans will have to pay that. What that means is that every person that has saved any money in a 401k, IRA, 403b, 457 plan, if you work for the state, you have gotten a tax deduction. But that doesn't mean that it's a permanent tax deduction. You will need to pay the tax at age 72, the required minimum distribution age. So what we're doing now is helping folks convert their traditional IRAs to a Roth IRA and voluntarily paying their taxes at the end of the year so that it can now become a Roth IRA and never be taxed again. So the money actually goes back into investments. The investments grow over time, and they don't owe any taxes on the growth of that money.
I can clearly see why it is so important that working with a gentleman like yourself, having a tax practice there, it seems like you would have to be very, very cognizant of where you are with the brackets and where you're going to be, whether it's a good idea or not.
Absolutely. And I think people don't realize what bracket they may be in today. So especially if they are nearing retirement, it's important to manage those tax brackets. And there are ways to actually reduce your tax brackets so that you can do Roth conversions at a lower tax bracket. And one way to do that is to start your own business in retirement. And that way, the expenses that you spend on that business allows you to have tax deductions, which lowers your marginal tax rate and your adjusted gross income, so that you could do your Roth conversions at a much lower rate.
That really is fascinating, how you are helping people. I actually can't get over that. The idea of somebody working, you know, you go to work, you do the job that that you're good at, and maybe there's that dream you had. You get to retire, you have the time, but you have the opportunity. You're helping launch small businesses, which is what makes America America, and also helping release people into get the opportunity to do what they're passionate about, what maybe they really wanted to do but never could. That is so cool.
Yeah, that's just it. People have had this dream of starting their own business, maybe going into real estate, maybe developing a product or a service, and they never really had the opportunity to do it while they were paying their mortgage, getting their kids through college, and funding all the things that they needed to in their lifetime. But now that all of that is done, they have the freedom and the resources to start their own small business.
How does somebody start the process of working with you?
So that's a great question. Typically, people come to me through referrals or through one of my webinars. We have a formal process that we use. And it starts with a fact finder so that we can learn about each person's situation, because everyone's different. Everyone comes from a different background. And so we want to know when they plan to retire, what resources they have in place in terms of their 401k or their IRAs or other funding mechanisms to help them retire, what their health care situation is. I worked for Blue Cross Blue Shield for many years. We do Medicare here. So we really take, we help people with every aspect of retirement. So it's Medicare, it's long-term care, it's estate planning, it's income planning, it's investments, all of that we're helping them with. So it's really a needs-based analysis, and then we formulate a plan, and then help them through that plan.
We're going to break right here. This is a perfect spot for to take a quick break that we need to take. When we come back, though, we are going to talk about something that 70% of retirees are going to have to deal with. Join us for more of Greg. We're going to talk about, we'll find out if you're in that 70% or not, what you can do about it on the other side of the break. Stay tuned.